Hey there everybody, and before the video comes on today, I'd like to take a second to thank the sponsors for today's episode of Caddicarus, App Bounty, which is an awesome little app service which I've actually promoted before, in which you download other free apps and in turn earn points which can then be exchanged for gift cards and spending money for Amazon, Xbox, PlayStation, Google Play, iTunes, Steam, Netflix, all sorts of things, and it can be used worldwide from any device. No, it's not an app where you can find bounties and earn real money from bringing them in dead or alive. You're sick. I'm promoting them again because of the new features that get you more rewards for actually playing through the apps that you download, essentially rewarding you for playing games on your devices that you may have wanted to play anyway. All you need to do is follow the instructions right below this video in the description for fast access, or instead go to appbounty.net and use the invite code CADDY with the correct uppercase and lowercase letters to get bonus points early and get the gift cards quicker. It's easy as piddle to do, it's unlimited, and if you don't want to use the app anymore or want to save space on your phone, you can always opt out and delete the app with no issue at all. You won't lose anything, but you won't get as many points compared to when you actually play the games. That's the cool thing. Anyway, enough of me rambling and on with the video.
I'm back!
Crashes back. Nickelback. Travis Bickle is the main character in Taxi Driver. Crashes back. Smack. Crash. Smashes and crashes the boxes, and that's why he's called Crash Bandicoot.
Crashes back. Fucking crushing milkshake. Busy. Special.
Shut the everlasting fuck up.
Ugh. Who's this? You're really rude. You must be American.
I'm not rude. You're just annoying.
Ah yes, it's Some Call Me Johnny, how could I not know? You're the only person that'd call me annoying, I'm a genius. Did you know that Crash is back?
Don't say it again!
Alright then, so in which case, do you want to do like a collab video about the new Crash on PS4?
Oh, well, yeah, sure. I thought you never asked. I'm willing to look past your annoying Britishness for a joint video about Crash Bandicoot.
You wanna do a Crash dance off?
Fuck off.
Hey, Some Call Me Johnny. Also, thanks very much to Activision for giving us early review codes for this game. They didn't pay us to make this video, but they were kind enough to do that, and our opinions are solely our own, okay, you little fucking children?
Holy shit, man! Crash Bandicoot!
Yeah, who would have thought he would make a resurgence in today's gaming climate?
I didn't think he would, honestly, but now I don't care. I'm ridiculously happy to not only say that Crash is back to his roots, but also say that for a remastering of three classic games 20-odd years down the line, the Sane Trilogy is fucking awesome, and is now one of my favorite games of all time because of how it already has one of my favorite games on it, but now updated, and with two other amazing games stuck to it like a sweaty scrote. And I think I'm more pleased to say that than most since I made my video not too long ago describing my feelings on everything I thought looked pretty bad about the new games in the reveal trailers, and boy, did it prove me wrong.
Well, that is of course if you consider this a total note-for-note remastering, nothing that new or fancy. There's a couple of bits and pieces added in for replayability and a few new features, but what you see is what you get here. Three classic PS1 games simply redone from the ground up, a lot, and thrown into a PS4 collection at a discounted price for 2017.
What you have here is not only a total visual overhaul with some of the most gorgeous graphics ever put into a cartoony platformer, but also much better control consistency over every single game. Crash plays and feels exactly the same way in every single game this time, but it is a completely different control style than before, focusing a lot more on pinpoint and precise jumping and maneuvering, and much faster and twitchier responses from Crash or Coco themselves.
Most of the time.
Calm down, John. We'll get there soon enough.
Okay. Well, either way, I think it's also worth mentioning that there's more underlying gameplay also present across every game. There's auto-saving now, making the first game a lot less of a ball ache, thank fuck. There's full analog control everywhere, but also the choice to use the D-pad whenever you press it, which is what I use, because when it comes to Crash Bandicoot, fuck this rubber nipple. And all of the bouncy Wumper Fruit crates now only last 5 bounces instead of 10 like it was in the original Crash 1 and 2, which I can only imagine you liked just a bit, Caddy.
Yes! By the way, John, did you ever wonder in the original games where Crash kept all of the gems and crystals he picked up in the levels? All this time, Crash kept them in his ears, in his stomach, and up his fucking ass.
Why is there a popping noise when he does that?
What? Have you never pulled a gem out of a Bandicoot's rectum before?
The fuck is wrong with you?
I also really loved the new animations and cutscenes. The animations within the game especially make this look like one of the closest things to a full-on high-budget 3D cartoon that you can actually play since Ratchet and Clank on PS4, all without losing the original point of Crash's chaotic goodness clashing against Cortex's insane evil. It's the same idea, just executed incredibly well with the updated tech, and the lip-syncing, bouncy stretching, and large amounts of charm present in them makes them really stand out and feel like a true step up. Even though I'm not the biggest fan of the intro to Crash 3 and how Uka Uka's introduction makes him have a total flying fit all over the fucking screen instead of his dark and imposing stance of total domination and power surrounded by shadows like in the original. And Entropy just arriving out of nowhere isn't anywhere near as threatening as his silhouette waiting in the background, then slowly walking out of the darkness as the camera zooms into his face of complete malice. I mean, what looks scarier to you? This?
From deep inside my temple prison, I sent you simple instructions to follow. But you lost the gems, you lost the crystals, and I have lost my patience!
All this.
From deep inside my temple prison, I sent you simple instructions to follow, but you lost the gems, you lost the crystals, and I have lost my patience!
But goddamn, I mean, I agree, the game looks fantastic, and I also agree that there was something a little lost in the presentation, but to once again use Entropy as an example, while his entrance is not as imposing as the original True, just check his facial animations during the Vortex scenes. I swear it's like I'm watching a Disney film. This is how far we've come since the 90s. And the animators did a damn good job getting all the little nuances down pat. Just from a simple change in inflection and eye movements, you can get that Entropy thinks fondly of Uka Uka, but doesn't really give a shit about Cortex.
Uka Uka and Dr. Cortex have sent me to end this little charade.
I personally also loved the improved, crisper and cleaner sound design and new sound effects thrown in to make the gameplay feel a lot better and more satisfying with running, jumping and attacking enemies.
Damn, I love smacking in the boxes in this game. You just find a nice big old pal and fuck smack!
Yeah, the sounds are perfectly mixed into the action, and the controller vibrations and heavy cartoony stretching animations of enemies reacting to your attacks are fantastic to further the game feel. The games overall, though, I found a little bit trickier with the more precise control tweaking. Apart from the first game, of course, that was just all much easier in my books, especially with the new control. Anything is better than the original game's controls. But in the other games, I still massively welcome the new control style. Crash falling to the ground after the top of his jump arc is faster than the last games, and that means that jumps are a little bit trickier to pull off this time since timing has to be more on the nose than ever. And yeah, what? It took me, what, about 3 or 4 stages in Crash 1 to get the controls down, but once I did, oh my god, I fucking loved them. I loved the weight, I loved the fastness of them. I just really loved the controls here. That made me, as a hugely nostalgic Crash fan, actually concentrate in all the levels that I know like the back of my hand, and I didn't rush through this game like it meant nothing because of that. I was fully invested, and I suppose there'd be no point of a remake if you didn't change how it felt along with everything else.
Most of the time.
Okay, John, fucking hell, you can share with the class in a bit.
I even really liked how if you die too many times, a random box to break in the stage actually changes into an additional checkpoint box so you can get yourself a little further and fall back less. And the enemies also tend to attack a little faster, along with some obstacles having totally different timings than I remember. I was surprised how many times the plants in Crash 2 managed to take a bite out of me. And these little electrical bashers in stages like Pissing It Away seem to have fucked up their hitboxes since the last time I played. The games definitely all feel different and can throw you off guard a lot, you know, if you grew up with these games in the first place. They're more consistently challenging than the original games, but never impossible, and new players will certainly have their work cut out for them.
How did you find the game played as well? Because I've heard so many people talk about how awful it was to be locked at 30 FPS, but we both played on PS4 Pro with the boost mode enabled, and I don't know, John, this doesn't look quite like 30 to me. I mean, maybe it's the animations in the game or the tightness in the control, but it never felt like it was running like that. It looked and felt way smoother. Maybe, I don't know, 40 or something?
No, it's definitely 30 frames per second. Listen, when you play so many fucking ports of Sonic Adventure 1, you learn a thing or two about frame rates. But 30 FPS or 60 FPS, I couldn't care, because I think the Insane Trilogy plays just fine as is. Though the amount of load times are slightly intrusive. Now, maybe it's because we both used the PS4 Pro, but they didn't feel that long. Nothing will ever beat Wrath of Cortex, but there's still a lot of them. And presentation-wise, it's just these boring black screens with no real visual flair. It harkens back to a more basic age, but ultimately breaks my immersion from the otherwise brilliantly colorful world of Crash Bandicoot.
I can't lie, though. It always does make me giggle in the load times whenever Aku Aku slides into the screen, like...
Did I ever tell you how much I fucking love your voice? Like, you don't only manage to make your points sound so cool, but also inherently sexual.
Thanks.
Anyway.
Okay then, let's get down to brass tacks and more specific. Are you ready to talk about a few things in each individual game, Johnny?
Yeah, you got them right!
Yeah! I mean, this was developed by Vicarious Visions with the assistance of the company that made Madagascar on PS2.
It's a relief to hear we're in good hands. Also, please keep in mind, we both have already done our own videos on the Crash Trilogy, and all that we loved and we didn't like about them, so yes. Since these games are practically identical in most ways, we won't go on for far too long about the base games themselves. Just take our words when we say, right now, that we already loved these games before playing them, and that hasn't changed with the remasters. They're still what we know and love. We're not gonna go crazy in depth with this video, instead just talk about the new thing. So let's start with this. I think this is the definitive and only version of Crash 1 you should ever play. Just about every single thing, in my opinion, is better here.
The visuals look so much better than the initial reveal I talked about in my video. A few camera angles have been slightly altered for better depth perception in scary platforming sections, and the new controls work so well for the more bottomless, pit-heavy, and claustrophobic level designs compared to the other games. It's even fun to jump on enemies this time around, and it's way more graceful and less clunky, if a little bit jarringly fast until, like I said, I played like a couple of stages and then I nailed it straight away.
If there's anything I would still consider a little dopey from the original game, it is the jumping, but for a different reason. Crash still weighs about as much as a waterlogged 10-ton weight, but compared to the original game, he flips and falls a hell of a lot faster in this game because I played the original too many goddamn times. It messed with my timing overall because I kept expecting Crash's feet to land in a particular spot at a particular time, but that doesn't quite work the same here. Nevertheless, it didn't take me very long to adjust, and even as a strict user of the D-pad, I still felt in complete control of my actions. Crash goes where I wanted to go with no issue, and thus when I screw up, it feels like something I did wrong.
The good thing is though, even if you aren't the biggest fan of the controls or prefer the older game's controls, literally every other thing is better in this game, and not just the fact that you can save anywhere this time. The inventory actually has a box-breaking tally this time. There are way more hints for you to discover secrets that are way too hidden in the past games, which applies to the rest of the trilogy as well. And when you collect regular gems, you can actually fucking die and not lose your chance to get the gem.
Thank God.
But when you want to get one of those few colored gems, you still need to finish the level, break all the boxes, and not die once. And wouldn't you know that Slippery Climb is home to one of these lovely non-death gems?
Oh, fuck you, Crash!
Don't worry though, because in my opinion, the vastly improved controls compared to the original first game makes these stages and staying alive nowhere near as hard as the original game. And on the colored gem stages in particular, if you find all of the Cortex, Brio, or Torna Bandicoot tokens for a bonus stage, but then die in there, not only can you retry it straight away, but it doesn't count towards a death in a stage.
Okay, I retract my fuck you, Crash. You've been a good boy today, so why don't you reward yourself and go fuck that pig? It's also great for Vicarious Visions to notice that the plot of Crash 1, you know, going to stop Cortex and save your girlfriend Tana, made absolutely no sense in the original since you could always find her and high-five her at her leisure in the treetops. Now when you find her in the trees, Cortex swoops in and takes her away, and little details like that, along with the fantastic visuals, more than make up for the fact that there aren't any ways to use newer power-ups, or even slide jumps in this, though I do miss those.
Come back to me!
Levels like Upstream and the Water Within look fantastic, as do, oddly enough, all the darker areas like the temples and even Road to Nowhere. Sometimes you don't need to go crazy with additions for the sake of no technology, and this game can do a lot with very little. Even if the lighting on occasion can look like total shit against Crash's fur.
Yeah, seriously, what the hell happened here? And what the fuck happened to the temple ruins theme as well? What used to be dark, ambient, and creepy as hell has been given jazzy, bouncy, happy accents where doomsday percussion would be used before, and it simply isn't as good in my opinion. But the rest of the soundtrack is great, and that's true over every single game. It uses all of the classic themes we know and love, but changes them up in ways to be a little bit more energetic and platformy on occasion. And most of the time, there are different instruments used instead of the memorable jungle percussion heavy tunes of the past. There's more diverse genres at work here. I mean, this is true across all three games. The original soundtracks are something that are near and dear to my heart, and I will always love them more. But as far as an update goes, I mean, it's the same compositions, but it just sounds much crisper and much better for a modern game. It's cool. Not to mention, it's not afraid to be atmospheric, and there are some tracks here that I actually think may be better than the original game.
The soundtrack gets a thumbs up for me, of course, and I agree that the remixes, for the most part, capture the original feel of the levels quite well, and yeah, some just sound playing better. But I think it's because I've listened to the originals for so long that I expect certain instruments to play at times, and when it doesn't happen, I'm a confused child and suddenly hate everything in the world. Don't buy this as a piece of shit.
Do yourself a favor though, Johnny. Don't do what I did and slave over the fucking time trial relics.
Yeah, I had a feeling they were a last minute inclusion.
Oh, were they? I hardly noticed. After around 2 hours or so, I managed to get every relic in the game with 14 platinum and 12 gold with over 100% completion, and I got nothing for it other than a PlayStation trophy. Oh, well, look at that. It even got me the platinum trophy. It was the last one I needed to get. That's very cool, I guess, but it's not fucking worth it. Stages like the high road with the huge gaps, difficult tiny platforms, invincible enemies, and timing with hitting the bouncy turtles at the right time and then leaping the large gaps correctly with them were a total nightmare for the relic. And even though personally I thought the time trials were a really cool little addition that do add a lot of replay value, when you place it in stages that were not built to be rushed at all, like in Crash 2 or 3, it can be pube-rippingly frustrating. I guess now I can brag about it, and I was very proud of myself for doing it, but man, it was so hard.
I also wondered to myself, like, I understand this is a remastering and nothing much more, but with all the conceptual levels present in the original game that never made it in, why couldn't they, you know, added them in here? If you check the trophies for the game, you'll notice another side game called Lost Treasures with its own trophies. And I hope to God it's free DLC or something that has these levels, because that'd be pretty sweet. Stormy Ascent, the beta version of Sunset Vista. Yeah, sure. I love getting kicked in the dick.
No.
Excuse me?
I'm answering a question I can already hear coming a mile away.
Well, I guess that means you don't want to do a Crash dance-off.
Cortex Strikes Back on PS4 is also, in my personal opinion, probably the best version of the game to have ever existed. I mean, yes, some of the things I worried about in my video are still present. I still think the theme to Hang 8 is over-exaggerated and unnecessary with the distorted guitars. But everything else I thought was pretty fucking great. The game is still so much better than I thought it would be. It's beautifully rich and vibrant as hell.
And hell is a pretty vibrant place last time I checked.
And I can't get over how modern and crisp yet cartoony and poppy it looks with all of the realistic effects like the rain and everything. And some atmospheres like in Snow Go I thought were absolutely on the nugget. And the animations are way better than Crash 1 on PS4 purely from the increased character interactions and cutscenes, with Embryo himself being a hilarious highlight with his animations.
I must use my forces to stop them from gathering crystals.
The fact the weather can change for different stages in the same theme is an incredible touch. The light reflecting off of the crystals and gems around the environment I fucking loved. The tiny little splash effects for grabbing the crystals I actually came to really like against the exuberant flashes of the previous games. And the warping effect looked a lot better than I remember it looking in the reveal.
I guess so, but where's the sound effect for the warping? Something that sounded so cool in the previous games. Now sounds like, well, nothing. And they didn't fix the camera for backtracking levels at all. Couldn't they at least move it back a bit? Yeah, I get it's a pitch by pitch remake, but why not fix what needed a little bit of fixing before?
Well, hey, at least I think they fixed the backpack levels tremendously. Along with the controls being way more reactive to inputs, it hasn't got anywhere near as much heavy momentum. You can invert the controls, use the triggers to go forward and back. It's so much more natural and makes the pathetic final Cortex boss all the more enjoyable as a result.
Mostly. Personally, I still hate the fucking thing, and I think the Cortex battle was just made even easier to compensate. The jetpack, for all intents and purposes, is the true final boss. I did think, though, that the updated snappy controls worked wonders on slide jumping, still just as satisfying and still just as incredible to do, and again, much faster and instantaneous without much hang time in the air compared to before.
But Johnny, look, there's no slippy slidey animation for when you're standing on these platforms in Ruination. Worst game ever, 2 out of 10, too much like Super Meat Boy, it's the Dark Souls of platformers.
But like I said earlier, though, everything that made Crash 2 the great game it is still here and accounted for. And it's less of a difference from the original game like Crash 1 PS4 is to the original. The platforming and level design is still top-notch and great to experience and challenge yourself with today. The difficulty curve is just right, even with all the hidden secrets and gems and alternate pathways for you to get the actual ending. And now there's more hints here for you to discover them. And I'm only going to guess as well that you didn't go for all the relics this time, did you, Caddy?
No, I did not. At least not for this video. After the agony I endured in Crash 1, I checked the trophy list and didn't see anything new that would happen if I did the time trials. So I will do it in my own time. Hell, you can even unlock the Crash Dash boots in this version of the game, so I'm excited to replay the stages in a much different and faster way. But for now, I'm not gonna take that risk.
Funnily enough, here's an update. I managed a platinum trophy every single game by the time this video was made. So there.
How about instead we jam out to yet another brilliant adaptation of the soundtrack, aside from the pre-mentioned Hang 8 theme. And sadly enough, the bear riding theme. It sounds too much like I'm playing the bonus level of a fucking Aladdin game. And because I do love the original game soundtrack a bit more, I do think it would have been very cool to at least have the option to choose between the remix songs for this game and maybe some uncompressed original pre-console mixes of the original soundtrack by Josh Mansell. In fact, he's actually uploading these original tracks onto his SoundCloud, so shout out in the description, go and listen to the pieces, they're a marvelous listen, especially if you love the original game soundtracks. It's sad to hear what could have been, but just didn't make it in. Going back to the game though, the ice physics have also been changed. They're much heavier than before, but a lot less slippy and more controllable, which makes the infamous stage of Cold Hard Crash and its hidden death route you then have to backtrack through a lot less of a flick in the nuts.
Oh, it's still a dick flick!
True, the ice physics aren't as bad, but unless you got invincibility from Aku Aku, you're still required to be painfully precise with slippery jumps between these goddamn nitro boxes, which I swear are closer together than they were in the original. And in the route itself, there's even a load of metal boxes shaped like a big middle finger to you. They knew. They fucking knew.
Okay, yeah, but now they do have the box tally, so that hidden box in the bonus stage isn't a problem anymore.
I don't fucking care!
Okay, fair enough. This bit still does suck, and with the ice physics specifically, it's different absolutely, but I wouldn't argue bad like many journalists are saying for the entire controls in general and comparing it to the fucking Binding of Isaac. Like Johnny said himself earlier, it is a tiny bit strange to get accustomed to the controls as a whole, but it only takes a few stages, and that's mainly because my mind is engraved to expect a different control style and physics when I look at Crash and the levels that he's running around in. It's not what I expected for sure, but not bad whatsoever, and if anything I thought it was awesomely different, which doesn't happen too often.
I mean, at the end of the day, it's still Crash Bandicoot 2, a game I fucking adore, warts and all. But now it looks better, it sounds better, and is now available for a new generation.
Oh yes, and let's not forget the Polar Splat.
Isn't it great to talk about Crash Bandicoot again?
Yeah, Crash Bandicoot.
Brash Candicoot.
Cash Banuka.
Rash Dandy Cunt.
Why do you have to ruin everything?
Well, 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 Crash 3 would be the hardest to please for me personally, since 3 was the first game I ever played and I love it dear to my heart. And so, do I think this is the best version of the game? Well, no, but I do see it on equal grounds to the original, which is still very high and fantastic. It does the most things questionably compared to 1 and 2's remasters, but it also improves in other areas, so I was happy it was done justice overall. I mean, Christ, I know this game so much that I was able to beat Engine without taking a single hit, so I was gonna be hard to impress anyway.
God damn, Caddy! Now, I do actually agree with you overall. Crash Warped on the PS4 is the same excellent and varied game from before, with a few things wrong, but still overall a brilliant time. With the controls especially, they even managed to improve the feeling of the baby T-Rex with a fast and less floaty control style, which can also be said for the waterboard in Crash 2 now that I think about it, and the plane stages are way more accurate with aiming as well as smoother to pilot, making the stages not only fun and shooting down planes fun, but also the final secret stage, Rings of Power, is a rocking good time.
And hey, John, if we're talking about smoother piloting, the bazooka controls are so much better than before. Nowhere near as sensitive, much more accurate, smoother to control, bigger explosion radius, no need to worry about hitting Wumpa fruit anymore and just explode boxes and enemies instead. I was impressed that they took the time to fix these things on a totally optional mechanic, and I actually ended up using the bazooka specifically way more than the original game because of how much nicer and satisfying it is to use. I even like the belly flop improvements, the smash radius is much larger, and it's a quicker action to perform in general. I use this a lot as well.
Man, I'm just happy to get my power-ups back at all because I love them so much. Yeah, I also use the belly flop a lot more because of its faster reaction time, but the double jump combined with the death tornado spin, fuck, I will never tire of that. The bazooka's great, the crash dash is just as thrilling as before, especially in the chase levels, and I was surprised to see that some glitches were still available, like the slide spin jump, which gives Crash extra hype, making encounters like Dingle Dow a total joke.
I mean, if you want me to nitpick, I noticed that there was a shadow on this mummy here, but not over here. And I also didn't like how the stage warp portals just kind of appeared really quickly and jagged out of nowhere instead of the smoother and slower inserts like it's growing from before.
Wow, that shit really is nitpicky.
Dude, I can't help it. I know Crash 3 better than pretty much any other video game. I was going to pay attention to this shit. However, like I said, for everything slightly questionable, the rest of the game is just as great as before, and if not, there's more greatness thrown in. Bosses, for instance, are just as adrenaline pumping as before, but with Entropy and Dingadal's case specifically, they were a lot more aggressive and faster to attack you, which was a great change and made for even better fights than they were before.
And hey, isn't it great to finally see Coco doing the crash dance? Look at her go.
And watch what happens when you get an invincible Aku Aku state while using the monkey bars as Coco. It's one of the most hilarious fucking things you'll ever see in a platformer. This footage, by the way, is not sped up. No. Oh, by the way, Johnny, what did you think of the animal controls over the three games? Personally, I thought they were alright, as stiffer and less natural feeling as before, but still responsive and worked really well. Very different and not as good in my opinion, but certainly not bad at all, and the stages weren't any harder because of them for me.
I thought out of all of them, the hog had the stiffest control, which is true in the original game to be fair, but veering left and right felt more like a struggle this time. It's appropriate given how Crash hijacks the animal. But I didn't think the bear or tiger controlled much differently, it's just I think the smoother animation psychologically fucked with me. It's more of an issue when I'm going for the relics. I missed more time crates than I could count, but during gem hunts where I could proceed at my leisure, I think they're just fine.
As for the other vehicles though, I thought the bike was pretty similar to before, and I love how zooming the screen out and slowing down the speed of the stage moving towards you makes them still very good. And with those changes specifically, the UFO stage that I hated before is now a million times easier and actually way more fun to play compared to the impossible guesswork of the original. However, this might sound like another nitpick, but this was really distracting for me. Whenever you jump off a ramp and land, there's a sudden screen jump every time you do it. I mean, I know it's trying to emulate the feeling of jumping off something and landing and it's all heavy and it makes the screen shake, but I don't know, this doesn't look right to me. The original game did this a lot better. This just looks like the fucking game's clipping you through the ramp and glitching. And John, what did you think of the Coco jet ski stages?
Jesus, what did they do to the jet ski? It's way heavier than before and can't turn as tightly, making box collecting harder to be precise with. It's such a pain when I pass by even a single box because now I gotta turn this thing around and just grab the box. This permeates through every ski level. Ironically, unlike the animal levels, I find it easier to speedrun these than gem hunting because being meticulous with this thing is a goddamn chore. And when all I have to worry about is driving in a straight line, then I guess that's okay.
Actually, you know what? Wait, Johnny, do you mind doing me a favor and turning on your famous
censored mode
from videos that you've done in the past?
Oh shit, if you need it now, this is gonna be good. Okay, it's on.
Brilliant, thanks, man. So with the changes to the jet ski physics and controls, and the fact that I wanted to get all of the gold or platinum relics for this game since you need the relics to unlock the secret stages, the hidden level, Hot Coco, can fuck right off and shove its hairy c*** down a fucking bastarding cut. I didn't mind the controls too much when you were just trying to get a crystal or a gem, but getting the fucking relic in the Hot Coco stage with its open-ended level design and bullshit box placement on other ends of the fucking stage, literal centimeters away from fucking death traps all of the time, is made a million times harder than it was in the original when you take away the less slippy and more responsive controls. Every single fucking time you want to jump over a fucking ramp, you need to be damn sure that you jump as straight as an arrow over that shit, because otherwise you slip and slide all over the damn place and hit nitro craze in the air. It's like in this game they were too focused on making it feel realistic and like you were actually skidding across the water, but that just makes everything more fucking frustrating. It's a platformer and the original game did this control fucking perfectly and it was really fun, so why did they change it? And seeing as you can't sharp turn anymore, hitting the time crates around moving bombs is a close impossibility when you're trying to fucking rush through everything. This stage, I swear to God, was just built with no thought to how possible it would be to complete with the time trial mode, and I played this motherfucking stage for about an hour and a half trying to get the fucking gold relic in under 30 seconds. Fuck this stage, and it's the worst thing I've ever done in a Crash game. You can turn off censored mode now.
Motherfucker, you broke the damn thing! I only had one of those!
Oh, it's not like you used it that much anyway.
Not the point, oh, it's working again. Well, now I can see why they call it the Insane Trilogy.
Yeah, too right. Because that part drove me
loopy.
Okay, well, let's end with a positive spin. This game looks and sounds magnificent.
Okay, yeah, to be honest, I think this is visually and musically my favorite out of the PS4 trilogy, with some stages like Gee Whiz looking fucking breathtaking when the sun rises over the background, and the calmer and more mystical approach to the Hang'em High theme, I thought I wouldn't like as much, but I actually really digged it. The drums, bass lines, different instruments and genres they're in. The original game was great, but now it really fucking kicks ass from the big band feel the tracks now have. However, I must protest against the wizard enemies not being in their underwear when you kill them. Right, so not having the slippy slidey animation in Crash 2 made this game a 2 out of 10, but now it's a fucking 0. This shit is unacceptable.
We'd never had that in the US version of the game, Caddy.
It's unacceptable! Overall, though, if you ask me, the Insane Trilogy is an awesome little collection and a must-have if you liked or loved the original Crash games.
I tell you, the Insane Trilogy is very much like the Super Mario All-Stars of the original Crash Bandicoot games. Enhanced graphics with enhanced sound and enhanced gameplay mechanics. Veterans have every reason to get this, and let's face it, you probably do already own this. But newcomers are in for a blast from the past as well, as they get to experience one of the few games that pioneered 3D platforming in the 90s with a beautiful fresh coat of paint. All for $40. I mean, let me see. I don't know the fucking price in the UK. Is Brexit still a thing?
Typical American.
Hey, don't start talking shit. I know my EB3s and my 1-2-C's.
Okay, so the Sane Trilogy is the absolute only way to play these classic games with all of the bells and whistles. And on the odd occasion, it isn't. But to be honest, with the amount of game you have here, the amount of great shit that you have here, the things it doesn't do quite as well, they don't really register. It's way too good of value and too full of effort and love to ignore. I do wish that at this point there was a little bit more additional content, especially for remakes this late on. I mean, having power-ups in Crash 1 and 2 would have been a fucking amazing option if you wanted to use them. But I honestly don't care, because I had a total blast from start to finish as I 100%ed the entire trilogy over a few days. I had the biggest goofy smile whenever I picked the game up, and because of that, it definitely gets the salvage.
Caddy, why didn't you just do that with the salvage gun?
Because I forgot to film it, okay, Johnny, leave me alone!
Aha! Now I have you firmly tucked into my grasp, and the tables are turned, you muppety malicious monkey!
Okay, fine. I give up. Let's do the Crash dance-off.
That was perfect.
Subscribe. Your hand.
Okay.
So smooth.
Yes. You don't only use your mouth.
Aha! Now the tables have turned. That will fuck.
Do you really want to do that Crash off dance off, huh?
The what?